The first one day you will lie for him. If your mentor is a thief, one day you will lie for him. The pictures you see there are pictures of me, not anybody. They are my pictures. It is the responsibility of fathers to teach their children. How do you make that 10,000 now? Jim, don't pitch anybody on that cup to go. Tell them what it costs for you to wear these shoes. Tell them what it costs for you to wear these trousers. Tell them why you don't come out in public and say, there is a price to pay to be who you are. Let them know that that 20,000 naira costs you. They live on your leg. There is a reason why there is a need. Our fathers are staying quiet and our children are becoming responsible. Until our fathers and our mothers are through that position, they are not going anywhere.
Follow this, my study, eat him until you
that statement because of time. There's something called the circle of life. If you are 30 years old and you are still in primary school, there's something wrong. Because there's expected that you should have gotten. Between the age of 0 to 6 and the years of innocence, from 7 to 13, there is foundation years when you learn how to speak your language, speak how to sing, how to do everything. Some of you may know twinkle, twinkle, little star, how I know that's what you do. But you know, my name. I can tell you the primary school in the old man. But when you get to 13, it's a year what they call Mabitzvah, celebration of manhood. As a woman, puberty starts, as a man, your voice changes, hair begins to appear. Something biological takes place in your body, something mental should have taken place in your head. Some boys that are 30 years old are still thinking like a 5-year-old child, and are there walking themselves, because they're supposed to think, because from 13 to 19, they're supposed to start envisioning. You want to be a doctor, you want to be an engineer, you want to be successful, you want to be an actor. But our parents say, no, sit in the house, I want you to become a lecturer, or I want you to become a doctor. So you become a doctor for them, or yet you want to become an actor. They kill your dreams. But at 20 years old, whether you like it or not, you are responsible to your life. You are responsible, you are accountable. If you are 20 years old and you are still in your father's house, it's a shame. Because at the age of 17, if you want to join the military in this country, you need a letter from your father. But if you are 18 years old, you don't need that letter from your father. At the age of 18, you can go to maybe like here and then pick up a form and tell them that they will enlist you in Nigeria and Nigeria, even immigration, custom, anyone, even man or woman, what's how they will enlist you. They don't need a letter from your father. They will take you to Kenya and then they will come to Kaduna and beat the nonsense out of you, put you to Zambia. But when they take you there, they give you a gun, life, armor. They teach you to shoot a gun. At the age of 18, Nigerian government can trust you with a gun and tell you that anything that constitutes a risk against Nigeria, a risk against the country, you are authorized to kill it. If Nigerian government can trust you at the age of 18, to defend Nigeria, why would you tell me you want to be poor at the age of 20? So if you are 20 years old and you are still in your father's house, it's a shame. In this meeting here, I beg you to take to the air, hear what you hear, and take steps to become it. The problem with Nigeria, the problem with Africa is free food. Free food. My big sister here, you have boys that are 20 to 25 years old, you spoil them. You give them one thing, eggs, the plantain, the beans, and by beans, and yam, they eat. They soon eat better than one, the juice, water, and then cook to top it up. Then by 11 o'clock, they're watching Telemundo, they're watching Zimbabwe. Then by 2 o'clock, 4 hours for Pandaya, with egusi soup, meat all over the place, so they have to push the meat to find the soup. Then the swells up in their soup, then they go to sleep. By 4 o'clock, they're watching La Liga, they're watching Championship. They know everything about Thierry Henry, they know everything about Arsenal, Man U, West Ham, Chelsea. They know everything about complete football, but don't know anything about their complete life. By 6 p.m., come, because we are looking at it as you are doing keto. So you don't need carbohydrate. All you need is fish and vegetables. So what do? They say, go to work. And they move out and go to a joint. Take 2 bottles of water to step down with total fish. 1 month, 2 months, 1 year, 3 years, 4 years. After 4 years, they come to church and say, Pastor, help me, there's a witch in my family. I'm going to expose that witch. Your mother and sister that gave you free food. When somebody gives you free food, they stop you from thinking. When they stop you from thinking, they stop you from producing.